Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Károly Zsolnai-Fehér. Have you ever wondered how your voice or your guitar would sound in the middle of a space station? A realistic simulation of sounds within virtual environments dramatically improves the immersion of the user in computer games and virtual reality applications. To be able to simulate these effects, we need to compute the interaction between sound waves and the geometry and materials within the scene. If you remember, we also had quite a few episodes about light simulations, where we simulated the interaction of light rays or waves and the scene we have at hand. Sounds quite similar, right? Well, kind of. And the great thing is that we can reuse quite a bit of this knowledge and some of the equations for light transport for sound. This technique we call path tracing, and it is one of the many well-known techniques used for sound simulation. We can use path tracing to simulate the path of many waves to obtain an impulse response, which is a simple mathematical function that describes the reverberation that we hear if we shoot a gun in a given scene, such as a space station or a church. After we obtain these impulse responses, we can use an operation called the convolution with our input signal, like our voice, to get a really convincing result. We have talked about this in more detail in earlier episodes, I've put a link for them in the video description box. It is important to note that the impulse response depends on the scene and where we, the listeners, are exactly in the scene. In pretty much every concert ever, we find that sound reverberations are quite different in the middle of the arena versus standing at the back. One of the main contributions of this work is that it exploits temporal coherence. This means that even though the impulse response is different if we stand at different places, but these locations don't change arbitrarily, and we can reuse a lot of information from the previous few impulse responses that we worked so hard to compute. This way, we can get away with tracing much fewer rays and still get high quality results. In the best cases, the algorithm executes 5 times as quickly as previous techniques, and the memory requirements are significantly more favorable. The paper also contains a user study. Limitations include a bit overly smooth audio signals and some fidelity loss in the lower frequency domains. Some of these scenes in the footage showcase up to 24 distinct sound sources, and all of them are simulated against the geometry and the materials found in the scene. So let's listen together and delight in these magnificent results.
This small room has a short reverberation time. Notice how the reverb quality changes as a listener exits into a larger area.
Thanks for watching and for your generous support, and I'll see you next time!